So there was a person in the time of the Holy Prophet who had a warehouse of dates, and he made his will: when I pass away, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam should come and distribute all the dates in this warehouse to the poor people of Medina. Such a nice will, such a nice wasiyat. Prophet comes, he's supervising some of those ashab and companions are going inside the warehouse, bringing the dates and distributing among the poor people in Medina in the supervision of the Holy Prophet. When all the dates were distributed and Prophet inquired, and he was told that, yes, Ya Rasulullah, nothing is remaining in the warehouse. This is where Prophet steps inside the warehouse himself. He goes there and he finds there's one rotten date on the floor. It's not eatable. Prophet picks up that rotten date and said, if this person has donated this one date in his own lifetime, he would have gotten more sawab than donating all the dates of the warehouse after his death. What do we learn from the story? We learn from the story that as long as I'm alive, my money belongs to me, myself, it's mine. This is the thinking that Allah is battling against. Allah is teaching us to get rid of this way of thinking. Money is not ours to begin with. It's an amanat, an entrusted trust of Allah. Anfiqu mimma ja'alakum mustakhlafina fi. We are the khalifa of Allah about the money. Anfiqu mimma razaqnakum. Give away from what we provided you. It's Allah's risk, it's not ours. This is the thinking of munafiqeen. They used to think, innama utituhu ala ilmin indi. This is the thinking of Qarun. It's not the thinking of Mumineen. This is my money. I made it with my hard work. You think your hard work makes you the money? And there are a lot of people who are doing hard work, but they don't end up getting paid. If the hard work was the sufficing reason for making money, then everybody doing the hard work should have been paid what he deserves. But that's not the case.